Okay. All right, well, it's recording. Hey, everyone, I'm Jem, and this is.
Hi, I'm Marita.
I'm so all this time I was calling you Martin, you know that. I just want to apologize. I've got your
Oh,
name.
Martin is fine. Like, so it's the same thing. It's just in Dutch, right? Like, we call it Martin, but don't worry. Like, Martin is fine.
It's okay. All right, well, you can call me Jim for the rest of the call. So,
Yeah,
what Martin and I are talking about, what are we talking about today? Because there was a poll on LinkedIn about you and I talking about a topic people want to discuss.
so there was a really interesting comment that asked us to talk about some of our failures, right? Like some of the stuff, like we did something, we did it wrong, like really stories from the trenches, not like the pretty theoretical, like when you introduce Scrum, you got to start with the leadership team, not these pristine stories, but the ugly, messy stories. Like, where hopefully there will be some nuggets of wisdom and maybe of us being idiots, you know?
I can definitely do the second one. I can guarantee that one. You know, when we're talking about mistakes, right? And Martin, we kind of like spoke about this very lightly. If I was to talk about a mistake, first of all, I know it sounds strange. How do I know it was a mistake? What even is a mistake? If I join a Scrum team and I want to go in there and I want to teach them how to, bring value for building a product, and I failed on that because I couldn't make it happen. What do you think about that? Like, how would we even determine that if it's a mistake?
I don't know. I think it's this moment when you feel like you're bumping into the wall, right? You're like, you're doing the same thing over and over again, and it isn't working. And then you try a slightly different thing and it's still not working. Like there's this realization, like maybe what I'm doing is wrong. And I think we're all a bit stubborn. Well, I'm very stubborn, right? And at some point you just realize this is not working. I need to do something different. And I think that all depends on how many times bumping your head in the wall you can handle, right? But I think that's the key thing. At some point, you're like bumping too much, and you're like, this is insanity. I'm doing something wrong. And it depends on your personality, I think, maybe.
I'm with you. So it's kind of like you're attempting to bring value, and whatever you're doing right now, it's not working. And there was a kind of situation we briefly spoke about. It's something specific. You join a team, and although they're called a team, they're not acting like a team.
Correct. So I was working at a company in Barcelona, like, and we were actually introducing Scrum to all the teams, and I was like one of the main drivers at this company. Like, I was a product owner, but like, I was like the Scrum person, let's put it that way. And there was this one team where Scrum didn't work, and I kept trying and I kept trying, and it was very frustrating for me. It was frustrating for them, and my final realization was, this group of people, Scrum's not going to work. And why it didn't work? Because it was a group of people working on integrations. One of them was working on Drupal, one of them on WordPress, one of them Salesforce, in different languages. So when we'd have the daily stand-up, one of the developers would talk about Drupal, one of them at WordPress, and they were not in sync. Like, and then we would have the forced retrospective, the forced this. And I just realized, like, let's just do Kanban, let's roll with it. Well, like, let's keep it simple. And whatever they want to do, we're going to do, but we're not going to force forward. And I mean, I have to be honest, I've never found a super effective way of working, but it was more effective than forcing Scrum. Let's put it that way.
Then what it was, and you know, when I'm thinking about this, like, so what I'm hearing is you've got individuals that have got their own specialisms, but they might be physically located in the same space. There's a bit of
Correct.
rapport. So they're more like a working group, and there's nothing wrong
Correct.
with a working group, but it's not a team.
Yeah, they were not a team. I think one of the core characters, a team has to have some kind of common goal. And if they have their individual goals only, it's very difficult to be a team. And that's what was the case here.
And just to play devil's advocate with you, right? You wanting them to do Scrum, what I'm sensing is, and you keep me honest, that you wanted them to, one of the characteristics of Scrum is a shared goal, a team goal,
Yeah, correct.
right? And you trying to do that and there being less interest, it wasn't a mistake that you tried, but are you saying it was a mistake because you tried it, it didn't work, and you tried it again, and you still carried on trying to do that?
Yeah, no, I think the biggest mistake is I now would not do that. Like now I would kind of immediately know I shouldn't do that. Like that's what I think was more the mistake. Maybe I was also a bit too stubborn. I tried for too long. I don't remember enough about that. Maybe, but I think that's difficult to change. I think I am pretty stubborn, and that has its good and bad sides.
It does, right? I think it's good. I mean, we all need a level of this might sound a bit radical, of ignorance to reach a goal, because if our optics are too wide, then you know what I mean? We may divert our attention everywhere. Let me ask you though, this is really interesting to me. Have you ever joined a team in a similar situation where they were a working group,
Yeah.
And you were able to convert them into a team.
No, to be honest, not. Like, to be honest, so here's my honest thing, right?
Mm.
I mean, if you're asking me, they were a working group due to the circumstances, right? Like, in the sense that they really, it wasn't possible to set a goal. I didn't change them to a team. But there were a situation, of course, where I arrived at a team where they're like a random collection of individuals not working together, and I got them to work together. Yeah, that happens. Right. But like changing the context, I think it's really difficult. Like sometimes, I moved, component teams to feature teams.
Yes.
But I've never had the situation where there was like one team that wasn't like having a common goal and made it. Maybe you have experience.
No, because, I've had similar experience with what you're saying. But what I found fascinating is what's determined something being a failure. Right. Was you're the person who hired me in. So I've been hired by a product owner that said to me, Jem, we've got a situation where some people are collaborating on a shared goal. Other people are not. So there's a bit of a, I hate to use this term, but there's a mindset thing or whatever. And I've never, ever successfully converted everybody. I think I have helped those who are already enthusiastic realize what they want.
Yeah.
And maybe those people in the middle of the road move towards the enthusiasts. But it's never, ever, the pipe dream that you might hear about a conference, everybody was doing everything perfectly. It's never that.
Yeah.
I've never seen it like that. I've only seen things become a little bit better, a little bit more collaborative, but some people have still worked in silos. Is that an improvement? Yes. Was it perfect? No. Should that stop you? No.
So what I can say is I did see that, but I think most of the time is it's due to the system, right? Like, it's kind of like, so I worked at a situation where where they actually said from one day to the next, everybody's going to focus on this. You have 3 months. This is the goal. It was a reasonable goal. Like, so there was buy-in and commitment. Everybody was working together. But I think the key thing is most of the time you have these departments with their own goals and managers have their own priorities. So it's the system that's working against you. That's what I think. Like, it's not just the people. It's also, it's the system. And if the system is working against you, good luck.
Well, and you know what, right? I massively concur. You've heard this quote, something like a poorly designed system will beat well-intended people most of the time.
Yeah, yeah. I think Deming said something similar. Like,
I think it is. Yeah. And just on that again, because you can tell, I love to argue against myself. I've also made the mistake of waiting for the system to be set up in such a perfect way that it stopped me from trying to build the case at the trenches to serve up the empirical data to talk about why we need to change the system.
Yeah.
You know, so I suppose, how can I say? We're never going to be walking into perfect situations. And you said something before that I really liked, which was whatever we're doing, you need to meet people a little bit of where they are.
Yeah.
Right. No matter whether it's a working group or a team or whatever the goal is, are we walking in with two ears and one mouth or the other way around?
So the way I visualize it, you need to bring them in your slipstream, right? There needs to be somebody that kind of takes the lead and gently invites them or nudge them in a direction. Mm. But there has to be a slipstream. And if you're too far ahead, there's no slipstream. Actually, in fact, you're slowing them down. You're going to frustrate them. Like, it's going to be, as they say in racing, I think, dirty air, right? It just makes everything worse.
Yeah.
And I think that's a good way of looking at it.
It is. And again, I'm going to annoy you again. One thing Tobias said to me, Tobias, right?
Yeah, I love him. He's a great guy.
He's exactly. He's always got these different faults. And many years back when we did the Agile Gorilla, he said, well, if I meet you where you are and you're an alcoholic, I may not want to meet you in the pub. Yeah. I may want to meet you somewhere else. So I suppose what I'm trying to talk about is that it depends. Sometimes there's a level of healthy disruption that's needed. And it's not a one size fits all. But I have
correct.
I don't know. I'm just saying I have made the mistake more of going in and not listening early in my career. And that has been more harmful. So that's been my edge.
Correct. You know? I made the same mistake. Like, I thought I knew it all. I think the best starting place is listen, help them with what they care about. And then in the back of the mind, you can have a little bit of your own agenda, like your own vision for where you want to go. But then you can bring them in because they trust you. Like, you have a relationship. You've got credibility. But start helping them, and then they will care about what you have to say. But until you do that, they're going to be like, who's this person? Why should I listen to him or her?
Yeah, I'm with you, man. If people don't know you're sincere and well-intended, anything is hard. Forget the knowledge of Kanban, Scrum, XP.
It doesn't work.
No, it doesn't. Okay. Right. We have hit 7 minutes and I
like seven.
Yeah, there you go. And I've been moaning saying, oh, we've got to keep this short and sharp. We don't know. We'd love your feedback. I mean, is there anything you'd like to add at the end of this, Martin?
No, I love this. And let us know if you think we should do it again. And also let us know what we should be talking about again. And yeah, I really enjoyed it. So I hope you will too.
Awesome. Thanks for your time, man.